Hi everyone, welcome to another video. Today I want to share with you how I made this rainbow background with some ink blending, and I want to show you how I used Amplify ink from Imagine. But first I want to remind you to follow me across social media. Those links are going to be down in the description box below. Also, while you're down there, you can subscribe to my channel if you enjoy my content, and if you enjoy this video, the thumbs up button always helps. For my card today, I'm going to go ahead and use the Lucky Charm stamp set from Joy Claire Stamps. It's an adorable St. Patrick's Day stamp set. But before I do that, I'm actually going to go ahead and start ink blending. For my ink blending, I am doing it directly on the card base. So I have an A2 top folding card base here. What I like to do is protect the back of my card base. So I just put a few pieces of masking tape to protect that while I'm working. It also secures it to my surface, and in this case I'm actually working over a piece of computer paper. That's going to catch all the extra stray ink, so I don't have to worry about smearing ink where I don't want to, getting it on my shirt sleeves because I was the brilliant one who made a rainbow ink blended background while wearing a white shirt. But beside that, I just want to be able to catch that extra ink so it doesn't go anywhere, slide around on me. For my colors today, I'm using Memento Dew Drop inks, and for my blending, I am using my ink blending brushes that are actually makeup brushes. I have a video all about these where I reviewed them. They are, I would say, pretty much the same as the Picket Fin Studio brushes. Mine are just a fraction of the price. I will leave that video linked in the top right hand corner, but I am using these because I really like the way they build up color. You start off small, you don't get those harsh lines, you build up the color with these. One thing I will mention is with these, you don't want to kind of tap in the ink pad. You want to rub your brush around like you would be picking up makeup. These are essentially makeup brushes. So smear it around in your ink pad and then come in and start blending. You can buff off a little bit of the extra ink if you don't want to, but really it loads into the bristles. You don't need to even do that. I am making a rainbow background, like I said. So I started with Ladybug, went to Tangelo, Dandelion, then I'm on bamboo leaves now, and I like to switch between two colors at a time. So I started off with my Ladybug, then went to Tangelo, and I would switch in between those two brushes. So I've got two brushes going at each time to make sure I get a nice blend. Then I went on to Tangelo and Dandelion, switch between two ink brushes, making sure that I got a really nice gradient with that. And I'm doing the same thing all the way across the card base. Now, if ever you feel like you're not getting a good enough blend with these inks, that's okay, because these dye inks will actually sit and kind of absorb into the paper, and they're going to blend out a little bit on their own too. So while this may not look perfectly ink blended right now, once it settles into the paper, it's going to look a lot better. I used, finally, this elderberry right in the bottom right-hand corner to finish off my rainbow. I'm going kind of at an angle here, and I'm switching between the blue and the purple now to get that really nice ink blended look. Once I am completely finished, I'm going to take a dry, clean brush and just brush over the entire thing. Make sure everything's nice and blended. I don't have any ink sitting on top of the paper. Then I can come in and peel off my masking tape from the back of the card base. Because I had that on there, my card base is nice and clean. No ink on the back. If you did happen to get any ink on the back, just take a sanding block or a sanding eraser and that'll take it right off. But there's a closer look at that rainbow background. For my stamping, like I said, I'm using that Lucky Charm stamp set. I'm stamping on watercolor paper because I will be using watercolor markers to color in my images today. I want to color in this rainbow how a rainbow really looks. And because of that, I wanted to do this quickly. I didn't want to wait for each section to dry. So I'm going to stamp with some VersaFine Claire Nocturne ink, which is a nice rich black pigment ink. Then I can also stamp my little pot of gold with my black pigment ink as well. I'm stamping a few of these just because I like to color in a few, see which ones I like better, and then I use that one. My watercoloring doesn't take that long, so I don't mind coloring in a few of these. Once I had all of those stamped, I did go ahead and heat set or add some black embossing powder and heat set that. That's going to create a little bit of a well, where it will hold in my watercolor. It's not going to bleed into other areas. This is just me being impatient. If you don't want to do the embossing, the heat embossing, you can always just wait for your watercolor to dry before you move on to the next section and it won't bleed on you, but I'm impatient. For my pots of gold, I am using, for all of my coloring actually, I am using my Arteza water brush markers. Or I guess they're the real brush markers, whatever you want to call them. All the supplies I'm using today, they're going to be linked down in the description box below. So if you have any questions about supplies or things I'm using, colors of inks, that kind of thing, all that information is always down in the description box. So head down there if you have any questions about that. I kept my little pot of gold, the pot itself, I kept it with some grays and blacks. Then I'm going to move on to the rainbow. Like I said, the little wells that are created with the heat embossing are going to allow me to color this in very quickly. However, I still didn't want to take the chance of bleeding, so I'm going to do every other little strip of the rainbow first. Then I'll come back in and fill in the other strips. So I started off with red, moved to yellow. I'm going to go in with this light blue. And for each one of my colors today, I'm using my Arteza water brush to blend that out. If you don't like water brushes, these blend beautifully with just a regular water brush and some water as well. I'm also working on the Arteza watercolor paper. It works really well with these markers. So these markers don't work well on regular cardstock, but they do work amazing on watercolor paper. I have a review on these markers as well. I'll leave that linked in the top right hand corner too. I came back in each one of those little sections that I skipped before, and I'm filling those in with color. I start darkest towards the cloud, and then I just dab the littlest bit of color down there and then bring it up with my water. That way I've got a nice gradient of color and I only had to use one marker. There's a closer look at those all colored in. I added a little bit of yellow to the little gold coins in the pot of gold, and I fussy cut each one out, but I didn't do that yet. I wanted to let them dry. While they are drying, I'm going to work on my little final piece here that's going to be my background. I have a piece of regular plain white cardstock. I cut this to 5.5 inches tall, and it is about 2.5 inches wide. I am using this cloud die that I just die cut, and I'm using that as my stencil to create my little cloud background. I'm using my Clarity stencil brush for this. This is the type of ink blending brush that I like for this technique. You could also use those makeup blending brushes. They would work really nice. You might just need a little bit of a smaller one, but I like these because they give the softest effect out of all my blending options. I'm using the VersaFine Claire ink in Paradise. I really like the tone of this blue. And then once I have everything on there, once I've got my clouds stenciled on, I'm just going to go over with my blending brush and blend everything out one final time. To add a little bit more interest to these clouds, I'm going to use this Neon Amplify ink from Imagine. It's basically, it puffs up. It's really, I love this stuff. It comes in this nice little tube with a fine tip nozzle, but you don't have to press super hard to get it to come out. And it's not in a marker form like some of the other products I've used. So it's super easy to get out the right amount, but you also don't have to fight with it. I'm going to zoom you in to see how I'm putting this on. I'm putting on a pretty thick layer right where those clouds meet the blue. So right where that stenciling started. I'm not going in a straight line here, and I'm also pulling some down as I'm working. I'm going in kind of a circular motion, making little half circles coming down out of the clouds. That's just going to add some nice texture and not make everything look so perfect. I'm going to do this to all three layers of the clouds. I'll show you this final one so you can see how I'm pulling down that product to make it a little bit wider. And then once I have that on there, you don't have to wait for it to dry. I go straight in with my heat gun and heat set. You need to let your heat gun heat up, but once it starts to puff, go ahead and move on to your next section. You don't want to hold it on there for too long because it will burn on you. So just make sure that you're moving on to the next section once it does its puffing. I'm just holding my heat gun on there, and I love watching this stuff work. Do you see how it puffs up? It's so neat. The thing with this product too is the less you put on there, the smaller amount of puffing you're going to get. But the more you build this up, the bigger puffs you can get. So I kept mine kind of a, I would say light layer, medium layer maybe, but you could really build this up if you wanted to. You could possibly even go in with another layer if you wanted to build it up even more. I'm going to show you this one final little puff up as I move my heat gun across just because it fascinates me. But once I had all three done, there's a closer look at that background. It's so much fun. And just by adding that little bit of texture, it really helped that background stand out and not just be kind of like your plain old cloud background that I normally do. Final thing for the background though, I did need to stamp a sentiment. So I'm using the Happy St. Patrick's Day sentiment from the Lucky Charm stamp set, stamping that down with Versifying Clear Nocturne ink, and I'm using my Misty to do that so I don't ruin my background that I spent so much time working on. Actually, wasn't that much time, but I didn't want to redo it. I also cut out each one of my little stamped images. I just fussy cut those very quickly and I used a black marker along the edges. If you don't enjoy fussy cutting and you have an electronic cutting machine, I do want to remind you that JoyClear Stamps does offer free SVG cut files. You don't have to pay anything extra. They automatically, you get them as a free download whenever you purchase the stamp set from the JoyClear Stamps shop, and then you can use them with any electronic cutting machine that accepts SVG files, which I believe most of them do. To set that background a little bit away from the card base that has a lot going on it, I just took a few pieces of black cardstock and just added the tiniest bit of a border or a mat to that background. That's something I like to do to help separate the layers a little bit because I don't want them to blend into each other. So that just adds that little bit of separation. For the background itself, I'm going to go ahead and pop up my stamped images. I'm using some foam tape to do that, just for even more dimension. I added the little rainbow on the left-hand side, and then I cut that cloud away from the second rainbow and used that to hold my little pot of gold. So it looks like the pot of gold is sitting on something and not just floating in midair. For the background itself, I'm going to go ahead and pop that up on the rainbow card base. I am using more foam tape for that, and I just pop that right in the center. Again, just by adding that little bit of a black mat or border to it and adding the foam tape, it's really going to help keep that away from the bright rainbow background. They're both going to kind of stand on their own, but they also go together very well. There is a closer look at the front of the finished card. I absolutely love the way this turned out, but I wasn't done yet. I did a little bit of stamping on the inside, nothing extravagant. I'm using the same Lucky Charm stamp set. I stamped a little shamrock on the left-hand side, and then I'm stamping I'm So Lucky to Have a Friend Like You on the right side with Versifying Clear Nocturne ink. Very, very quickly, I grabbed an Arteza brush marker, and I'm going to color in that shamrock super duper quick. This isn't going to be the prettiest coloring because I did it on regular cardstock, but I also didn't want to use an alcohol marker and have the bleed through on the back. But once I had that done, that completely finished off the card today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was a lot of fun to make this card. A lot of components, but once you get them done, the card comes together pretty quickly. That does it for me today. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. There are going to be links on the left side of your screen you can click on. Don't forget all the information down in the description box. Happy crafting, everyone.